Dear students, in my previous lecture part 1, I have already covered about the various chromatographic techniques used in the isolation and identification of the crude drug. In this part 2, I will cover rest of the chromatographic technique used in identification and isolation of crude drug and the electrophoresis techniques used. Let's start. This is the unit 5, lecture 2. Part 2. In this part 2, we have already studied in part 1 about the application of latest technique chromatography, some of the chromatographic techniques. Here we will study rest of the chromatographic techniques and electrophoresis in the isolation and purification and identification of crude drug. Now, what are the topics we will cover in this? I have already told you in part 1 about the definition of the chromatography, isolation of the purification technique, classification of the chromatographic techniques. So in this part 2, we are starting with various chromatographic techniques used for the separation, electrophoresis. Now, isolation and purification of crude drug are the same as I have continued this lecture for the chromatographic techniques. Now, the rest of the techniques employed in the isolation and purification of the crude drug is, there we have stopped on column chromatography, right? We have studied TLC thin layer chromatography, column chromatography, high performance liquid chromatography. Here we are studying gas chromatography. What is gas chromatography? GC. Gas chromatography is also known as gas liquid chromatography. It is a separation technique in which mobile phase used is gas. The only difference is, in case of solvent, the mobile phase using here is gas. And now we are also using the combined techniques for more easier separation and the yield. For example, mass gas chromatography. In this method, the choice of separation of volatile substance or the volatile derivative of certain non-volatile substance. So we can separate these categories. Stationary phase here is used is a solid material, Kieselguhr, or the mobile phase used is the gas. And the higher a component's affinity for the stationary phase, the slower it comes to of the column. The components are then detected and represented as a peak and the chromatograph. The most important, that is, this technique is used for the estimation of lipids, separation of vitamins and drugs. This is the figure of gas chromatography. Here this is the gas, carrier gas, which we are using. Here we will inject the sample. These are the columns. Here the detector will detect and then we will get a chromatogram with the help of computer. So a system is also attached with the GC. Okay. Now next, HPLC. High performance liquid chromatography. High performance liquid chromatography is a form of column chromatography which utilizes column as a packing material of particle size of small size and the regular size. The same like column chromatography, the main advantage of HPLC is higher yield, better efficiency and the resolution. What are the advantages? Quantitative analysis, the components of the mixture at a high level of resolution, I have already told you. Synthetic and natural pharmaceuticals, food analysis and biochemical researchers find great applicability. Nowadays, biochemical separation are done with the help of HPLC. Therapeutic drug monitoring in the clinical research. In clinical research, we require to monitor the drug. So HPLC is used, is a technique which can be used in this clinical research. What are the different uses of HPLC and what is the main application of HPLC? HPLC is mainly used to perform structural and functional analysis and purification of many molecules. If we want to detect the structural and functional group of any molecule, we can use the HPLC. The technique also yield the separation of amino acids, carbohydrate, lipids, steroids. And in HPLC, the mobile phase passes through the column under 10 to 400 atmospheric pressure, and the flow rate is also very high. In this technique, the use of a small particle in the application of high pressure on the solvent flow increases the separation power, and the analysis is completed in a very short time. So the main advantage is a short time, less time consuming, effective resolution. This is the pictorial for the HPLC, high performance liquid chromatography. Here this is the solvent, these are the pump, here we inject the sample, this is the column, and here we get the chromatographic with the help of system. These are the detecting systems and these are the outlet for the waste. The same like the column chromatography, only the technology is attached, more easy and convenient. And the next comes the high performance thin layer chromatography, thin layer or thin liquid chromatography. High performance thin liquid chromatography is very useful qualitative analysis method. It is useful for the qualitative analysis. Quality, which type of constituent present. And this HPTLC is mainly the short duration is the and the better resolution. And it is divided into mainly 6 to 7 points. First is sample application. We'll apply the sample. Next, preconditioning, mobile phase, chromatographic development, then the detection of spot, and at last is the scanning and the documentation. So these are the steps for the HPTLC. Sample, how do we prepare the sample? It needs a high concentrated solution. It's very less amount sample to be needed. Amount of sample should be less, but the concentration of sample should be more. For normal phase chromatography, we are using silica gel. Plate solvents should be non-polar of volatile types. For reversed phase chromatography, we can use polar solvents. HPTLC, first one, I have told you sample application. These are the points you should remember in case of sample application. The size of sample spot which you are applying must not exceed 1 mm in diameter. And there are different techniques for spotting the sample. The most common technique is capillary rise method with the help of capillary. Next is preconditioning. Preconditioning means chamber saturation. You have already done this chamber saturation in TLC. Okay. Next is mobile phase. The solution of appropriate mobile phase is by trial and error, in which chemical properties of the solute and the solvent depends on the adsorbent layer. All depends on the chemical property of the solute and the amount of solvent raised. The next is chromatographic development. The linear development method is the most familiar type. The chromatographic development or the chromatographs which are developed with the help of capillary, application of capillary, are the chromatographic development. Next is the detection of a spot. Immediately after the development is completed, the plated are removed from the chamber. We can measure the plates in UV chamber also, dried, free from mobile phase. It should be dried. After that, the spot should be detected. And iodine vapor chamber is also used. Scanning and documentation. The HPTLC equipments are now compiled with the computer and the whole software system. So you will get the scanning and the documentation or the chromatography in a perfect way. This is the pictorial diagram for the HPTLC instrumentation. You can see how the development is done and different types of scanners and the detecting systems are attached. Next is ion exchange chromatography. Ion exchange chromatography mainly depend on the cation and the anion exchange, that is positively charged and the negatively. The basic principle of ion exchange chromatography is the cation exchange chromatography and the anion exchange chromatography. Means cations are negatively charged stationary phase with negatively charged functional group, and is used when the molecule of interest is positively charged. And anion is used when the molecule of interest is negatively charged. And this is the pictorial diagram of ion exchange chromatography. These are the positive charged beads, positive charged proteins, negative. In this way, this type we will use to separate out the different particles or compounds, active constituents. Next is the gel filtration chromatography. This chromatography is mainly used for the protein separation, and it is useful for the determination of the different structure of the proteins. This chromatography is also known as size exclusion chromatography or gel permeation or gel filtration, and separate molecule according to the size and their molecular weight. The main is they are separating according to their size and the molecular weight. This is the pictorial for the gel permeation. For example, these are the column, these are the gel beads which we are using, and the protein solutions. And in this way, the separation is done. Now, next comes the another technique, that is electrophoresis. Electrophoresis is also used for the separation of the protein, amino acids. The main amino acids and proteins are generally separated by the use of electrophoresis. And in biochemistry, the use of electrophoresis is of utmost importance. What is electrophoresis? Electrophoresis is the migration of charged particle or the molecules in the medium under the influence of the electric field. Means this instrument is attached to the electric field and a gel bed is there. So the movement of charged particle, the amount which to be separated is pointed or is spotted on a gel bed. Okay. Next, the rate of migration of ion in electric field, mainly the electrophoresis depends on this factor: net charge of molecule, size and shape of molecule, strength of the electric field, properties of the supporting medium, I am talking about the gel, temperature of the operation. These are the pictorial representation for the electrophoresis. This is the gel bed, electrode attached, electrophoresis tank. Here we fill the buffer solution. You are seeing the sample wells. We are putting the well of the sample here, and these are the, you are seeing the seam in the this way. This is the sample well, and the beds or samples are separated according to their affinities. Okay, what are the questions which will cover this topic? The important question you should go through is application of HPTLC in the evaluation of plant constituents, define electrophoresis, what is the application of electrophoresis, principle of HPLC. Then these are the references from where I have taken the matter, and I will also provide you the notes from my side. Thank you. Be safe, stay healthy.